Hello everyone, this is going to be a quick tutorial on how to set up a dual PC live stream without a capture card on a Windows machine. Why would you want to do this? Because it frees up resources on your gaming PC, so you can run at higher settings. You know, you can increase your frames per second, less input lag, and a bonus, you don't have to pay money for a capture card. All you need is a good router and an Ethernet cable. Really quick. This is common sense, but just to, you know, inform you, you want to have a good GPU on your gaming PC because it's for the gaming, and you want to have a pretty decent CPU for your encoding PC because it's going to be doing all the heavy lifting as far as processing. This is like my first tutorial, so bear with me. I hope this helps you guys out, and here we go. Okay, here's a brief and quick tutorial on how to make a static IP address for your encoding PC, which is important because you don't want your IP address to change. That IP address is going to be used in multiple applications, so it has to stay the same. On a Windows PC, you can hold in the Windows key and press R. It will bring up the run command window here, and you want to type in CMD, and then from there you want to press enter. And inside of the command prompt, you want to put in ipconfig/all and press enter. There's three things you want to get from here that's important. You want to look for your IPv4 address. You want to take that number down, and you want to get your subnet mask, which is usually always the same for everyone. It's 255.255.255.0. And you also want to get your default gateway. I said three things. You also might want to take down your DNS servers, which in this case is the same as my default gateway. Okay, once you have this information, you can go ahead and close out the window. What I do is I go down to the network computer down here in the lower right. I right click it. I go to Open Network and Sharing Center. And then from here, I go to Change Adapter Settings. Once you're inside this menu, let's try to make it a little bigger for you. You're going to get your Ethernet connection right here. I right click, go to properties. Inside the properties, you want to look for your IPv4, which is here. You want to highlight it and you want to go to properties. Now, this is where you input some of the information that you took down. You want to go to use the following IP address, and this is where you put your static in. Okay, so what you want to do, if I can actually type, what you want to do, and I messed up again. You want to leave the first three numbers or the first three boxes here the same for your IPv4 that you took down. And for your last number, you want to make sure you stay in your IP range, but you want to change this to something you can remember easily. So for this tutorial, I'm going to put 135. And once you do that, you can press tab. And most of the time when you do this, 255.255.255 will automatically populate inside of here. If not, just put that in there, put your subnet. Your default gateway, you took that number down. Why do I keep pressing 5? You put that number in there too. And then you want to put in your DNS. Okay, so once you have all that information in, there you go. You have a static IP address. We're going to go ahead and move into step two. Okay, for this step, if you haven't already, we're going to go ahead and download OBS Studio. You want to go to obsproject.com. You want to click on Windows because we're doing a Windows tutorial here. And just go ahead and install it. Once you have it installed, you're gonna have a window that looks like this. This is OBS Studio. What I did, you don't have to do this, is I set a profile name to RTMP so I don't have to keep changing the settings when switching between, you know, the consoles and other PC setups. From here, you wanna go to File, you wanna go to Settings, you want to go to stream, and in stream type, you want to choose custom streaming server. For the URL, this is the format. This format has to be correct. You want to put rtmp:// that static IP address that we made earlier in the tutorial. You want to put that here. Then you want to close it with another /, and the word live at the end of it. For the stream key, for tutorial purposes, name this test, because we're testing this out. We just want to get you started. Output. A lot of people use the NVEC, or the NVENC encoder. I use the QuickSync. For me, it works better, but you can play around with these settings. You can copy this right here. This is what works for me. Just copy that down and click apply when you're done. Audio is default. Video, this is also preference. And then you click OK. So you're pretty much done now. From here, this is your gaming PC and it's all set. For the streaming PC, there's two steps. The first thing you want to do is you want to go to the website that I left in the description and download Nginx. Once you get Nginx, what you can do is you can right click. Well, let me tell you this. Most people prefer you put it on the C drive. I put it on a desktop. And what I do is I just pretty much just extract it here and I run it from a folder. Once you get the folder, you want to open the folder. And you will get Nginx executable, Nginx basic. So to get Nginx to run, you want to get the first one right here, which is Nginx executable, and click. You'll see the command prompt pop up and it'll go away. In order for you to be able to tell if you have Nginx running, you have to press Control Alt Delete and go down to your processes, scroll down, and you will see the Nginx is running. So your server is all set. You do not have to play with any settings. Not for my tutorial. So everything is default. Okay, guys. On a streaming PC, you just want to set it the way you would set, you know, if you were just streaming on one PC. So you want to go to settings. You want to go to stream. You want to go to streaming services. For me, I'm using Twitch, so you go to Twitch, pick your server, and then get your Twitch stream key, and you put it in here. And then once you have all of the information, you click apply. You know, you set your output and audio and video the way you want it. You click apply, which I won't be doing here. And then we go on into the RTMP settings. Okay, guys, now the Nginx is set up. This is the final step. On your encoding PC, you want to make sure that in OBS Studio, you want to go to scenes, name it whatever you want. But I named it RTMP because that's what I'm going to be using. And you want to go to sources and you want to add a media source. You can name it whatever you want to. I'll just leave it media source. Inside the media source window, you want to uncheck local file. And just like on the gaming PC in the input, you want to definitely keep the same format here. And you want to type in the static IP address that we created earlier. Oops, something looks wrong here. Okay, too many ones. Okay, so then we're going to close it with a /, and then live again. But this time, remember that key that I told you to make? We named it test, so it's easy to remember. This time you're going to put test, because that's your stream key. And then for the input format, you want to put RTMP. And then you want to click OK. Now you're all set. That should be it. Okay, since Nginx is already running, all you need to do is press stream on your gaming PC, which will send the information over to your streaming PC. Go ahead and press start streaming on your streaming PC, and it'll send the information to Twitch and then out to your fans. Play around with the settings. I gave you some basic settings. You can change them to fit your needs, but I hope this tutorial helped you. I am very new at this, so bear with me, and I Hope to see you guys again soon. Peace.